Hi everyone, in this video I want to talk about what Jacobi iteration, also known as Jacobi method, is and the benefits to it. In the next video we will go through slowly and solve a problem using Jacobi iteration. So, between these two videos I will ensure that you have a firm understanding of how you can implement the Jacobi iteration to solve your own problems. Alright, so let's get into what the Jacobi method is. Jacobi method is an iterative numerical method, meaning we iterate or take many steps to get from our starting position to our final answer. And every step that we do take will be one towards minimizing the error of our problem. Then we will continue this iteration until we reach an acceptable level of error. Before I begin, I should note that you cannot use Jacobi iteration when you have a singular matrix. This means that the matrix has no solution. And I will post a video in the description below if you want to learn more about singular matrices. So, the steps to solving a linear system of equations using Jacobi iteration are the following. Firstly, we make a guess for every value in your X matrix. Therefore, we need to assume a value for X1, X2, X3, etc. for as many X values as you have. Let's call our initial iteration 0, as many programming languages, like Python, have 0 indexing, meaning we start counting from 0 in them. However, if you are using MATLAB, begin at 1 as it does not have 0 indexing. A typical starting guess is just a 0 matrix, unless we have some additional information about the problem that could help our guess. The benefits of having a better starting guess is that we can achieve our final solution in less iterations. Now, step 2, we need to write all of our independent equations and have them all solve for different x terms. So you can see here that I have done that. Number 3. So once we have rewritten our system of equations, it is often wise at this point to create a table to summarize all of your relevant information. This is how I would recommend making your table. However, as long as your table has all the important information on it, and you understand it, that is all that matters. Step 4. We are now ready to solve for our iteration 0. We plug in our assumed values into our system of linear equations, and these output values are going to be the values used in our next step, or our next iteration. Step 5. As I said, these newfound x values will be our new guesses. So, we will repeat what we'd completed before, and plug these values into our main equations again. I should also note that sometimes you will see the iteration number denoted in parentheses in the top right corner of the x variable. So, if you do see that, that is what that means. Step 6. You just keep completing iterations until you get close enough to your acceptable amount of error. If you were coding this, then you would just verify that the right side of all your equations is within your error tolerance to your left side of the equations when all of the current iteration guesses for x are entered. If you are writing this out on a test for a simple system of linear equations, you could just simply plug in all of your x values for your equations and see how close they are on the left and right side. As I've stated earlier, if you wish to practice the theory that I just went over in this video, then check out the example video I'll post in the video description below. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we solve a system of linear equations using the Jacobi iteration method. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.